I am Dr. Bharat Jain. I am interventional cardiologist with about 6 years of interventional practice, working at various hospitals around Mumbai and at Dombivli. So the topic which I have selected today is test for a healthy heart. Basically, many people come to the OPD clinic with various blood reports done, various schemes done, lots of combined tests which are very popular among people and get themselves evaluated. All these tests routinely for every individual is not usually recommended. We can have selective tests which usually should be prescribed by a doctor after a proper clinical evaluation, thorough physical examination, and then if there is any need for a test, the test should be done. The trend which is usually taking place is getting a lot number of tests done just for your health checkup, which probably may not be the right thing to do. So coming to the World Heart Day message, which I want to give it to you, India is gradually becoming the capital for heart diseases. This is mainly because we have already overtaken various countries in the terms of number of diabetic patients, hypertensive patients. Our ethnicity, or as an Asian ethnicities, we are already high risk prone for development of coronary artery disease or heart diseases as we call them, and a rampant use of tobacco in our country. So these four or five factors is most important factor because of which we are gradually becoming the capital of heart diseases. Some of them factors are modifiable risk factors like the control of diabetes, hypertension, smoking, stress. These are all modifiable risk factors, means in the sense that they can be modified by some intervention and your risk of developing of a heart disease reduces significantly once these factors are modified. So coming to the test which I am going to speak about today in this session will be basic test about a good physical examination, the test for blood pressure, the test for diabetes and your lipids. Lipids, cholesterol are one of the most important factors as precipitated for known factor for coronary artery disease and also for brain strokes and various other ailments. Coming to a good physical examination, when you go to a doctor, a clear-cut history is very important under your previous medications, the presence of any treatment which you have started on, any known drug allergies or any issues which you are facing now should be discussed and dealt in detail. Most of the time what we see in clinical practice is patients comes to us who are known case of hypertension on treatment but always in a denial mode. When we ask them if there is an history of blood pressure, they usually say no. This no is because they are taking medicines and they are not showing any symptoms because of blood pressure or diabetes. So these things are very important to know what exactly you are taking medicines for and to disclose that you are on such certain medicines. Coming to blood pressure is one of the most important cause for any neurovascular or cardiovascular event. Blood pressure of more than 140 by 90 is supposed to be termed as hypertension, and there are various stages by the Indian guidelines, European guidelines, American guidelines for treatment protocol to be started. All patients even on the range of 140 to 150 need not be started treatment on the day of visit. They can be gradually monitored by lifestyle modifications, dietary changes, and then can be recalled after 3 to 4 weeks to reassess the blood pressure, and then if needed a treatment should be started. The target of blood pressure in various groups should be about 130 by 80. All cases of diabetes, kidney disease, all should be in that same range so that the medicines has to be titrated. Just taking a single medicine irrespective of your blood pressure control does not work. You need to monitor your blood pressure, you need to do frequent testing to know what is the cause for your blood pressure, and then you need to evaluate and treat that blood pressure. For the treating of blood pressure also, when you are diagnosed with blood pressure, your doctor may order a list of tests like your thyroid function test, like a sonography abdomen, like a renal artery Doppler, your electrolytes levels, various other tests like maybe a urine 24-hour urine levels. These tests are usually done to see if your hypertension which you have got is because of some secondary cause, and this is usually termed as a secondary hypertension. Coming to diabetes, India is already becoming the diabetic capital, and most of the patients are uncontrolled diabetes who present very late with multiple micro or microvascular complications. We have seen many patients who are presenting with acute heart attack and are diagnosed as diabetic during in-hospital admission. So diabetes after the age of 40, annual diabetes sugar checkup is compulsory, should be done. And earlier so, if you have got a family history of diabetes or you have diagnosed with symptoms of diabetes, earlier testing should be done. A fasting level of more than 126 is usually suggestive of a diabetic stage, or an HbA1c of more than 6.5 as per the ADA recommendations. During treatment, your fasting should be less than 1, between 80 to 130, and your postprandial sugar should be less than 180, and your symptoms should have been significantly reduced, and try to get the HbA1c level to less than 7. Each percentage increase in the HbA1c is known to increase your risk of developing any further event. Now coming to dyslipidemia, most of the patients who come to the OPD with a lipid profile report usually have a range of slightly increased cholesterol level, about 230, 240, borderline triglyceride levels. These are not to be worried about initially. Your first target should be getting control of your LDLs level, which is a low density lipoprotein and which is supposed to be the bad cholesterol level. This is most important target, which is the first target which should be done, and it should be less than 130 if in a normal individual, and less than 70 in high risk individual, and less than 55 in very high risk individual. Then the second target that should come into mind should be your HDL cholesterol, which should be above 45 in male and 55 in females. These two targets are very essential to achieve, and then other targets of cholesterol level can be achieved gradually. Just treating for a total increase in the total cholesterol or slight increase in the total triglyceride level with a medicine or a statin is usually not to be prescribed. These can be managed by lifestyle modifications and a repeat lipid profile checkup at 6 months of follow-up. And then maybe an annual lipid report should be done to see if your lipid status is under control or not. So basically these three things are very important when you first go for an initial checkup: your sugar reports, your cholesterol reports, and your blood pressure measurements, because these three things are the most important group which is the major risk factor or a modifiable risk factor for development any of any heart related issues. So the basic blood tests which are required are these tests, which will give a snapshot of what your ailment is and if you need to be on any treatment, and if you need to be on treatment for a longer duration of time.